Who is this young boy? What is he scribbling on a whiteboard? What is MR and MC? Let me tell you, that boy is me, and in a few seconds, you're about to see his nipples. My nipples. There they are. Aren't they magnificent?
The path of the righteous man is beset on all sides by the inequalities of the selfish and the tyranny of evil men. Blessed is he who, in the name of charity and goodwill, shepherds the weak through the valley of darkness. For he is truly his brother's keeper and the finder of lost children. And I will strike down upon thee with great vengeance and furious anger those who attempt to poison and destroy my brothers. And you will know my name is MR equals MC. Okay, there we go.
All right, so MR equals MC is the crux of profit maximizing rule. And this is not a super difficult concept, but it is super important. So the main thing that you need to take away from this is that MR equals MC when you want to maximize profits. This doesn't mean that marginal revenue is the same thing as marginal costs. It just means if you're ever looking at a graph and you want to find where firms produce to maximize profits, it's always where MR intersects MC. This is the most important takeaway from this unit, and we're going to drill the hell out of it in this video. So, we know that we want to produce where MR equals MC, but we don't know why yet. So let's look at this graph I made here of this unnamed firm. They sell units for $5 each. As you can see, they have a marginal cost there, a marginal revenue. This is just your average everyday firm that you're going to see a lot of similar firms like this all throughout your PE firm. And we want to know why they want to produce at MR equals MC and why that would make the most profits for them. I know when I started this class and I saw these graphs, I thought to myself, why don't they just produce where marginal cost is the lowest and where marginal revenue is the highest? Because if they produce there, then they're going to have the most revenue. But that's not the case. That would be true for total cost and total revenue, but we're looking at marginal, how much it costs and how much they make from the one additional unit. So if it says 10 there, we're looking at the cost of the 10th unit and the revenue they get from the 10th unit. That's why marginal revenue is a straight line, because if each unit costs $5, then for each unit, their marginal revenue is going to be $5. So a good example to demonstrate this is to see, okay, well, why don't we produce where marginal revenue is really high, where marginal cost is really low, at $1. I mean, at one unit produced. So if we produce at one unit here, we go over and we look at our cost, and our cost is going to be about $1. And if we look up at our revenue, we're going to see that our revenue is $5. So if our revenue is $5 for one unit and $1 cost, we're going to have about a $4 profit for that one unit. So you think, okay, $4, that's pretty good. And it looks like it's decreasing as you produce more units. So why would you want to produce more if your profit per unit is decreasing? So for instance, if we look at producing at 5 units, well, now the cost has risen to $2 for that unit. and revenue stays constant. So at $5, they're only going to be making $3 as opposed to the 4 of one unit. 3 instead of the 4. But you would still want to produce at 5 rather than 1, because at 5, you still get the revenue from unit 1, because this is marginal revenue, not total revenue. So when you produce at 5, you not only get the $3 profit from that 5th unit, but you also get the 4th unit profit, the 3rd unit profit, the 2nd unit profit, the 1st unit profit. Each time you add a new unit, you still make the profits of the previous units. So let's look at somewhere like unit 7. Unit 7, we get only $2 profit, but we have to remember that we're still getting the $3 from unit 5 and all of the dollars from the previous units. So there'd be no reason to produce at unit 5, because if you produced at unit 7, you'd be getting all of the previous profits, but also the extra $2 that you get from producing the 7th unit. So why don't you just keep producing forever? Well, the reason that you don't want to just keep adding units produced is that not all units produced make you a profit. For instance, over here at unit 15, our cost is $7, and we're still only making $5. So by producing here, your total profit would actually go down, because you're losing money by producing that 15th unit. And that's true of any unit after the 10th unit. So remember it like this. If your marginal cost is higher than your marginal revenue, then the unit that you're producing is taking away from your total profits, because the cost of producing that unit is greater than the amount of money you make from it. But if your marginal cost is less than your marginal revenue, then while that unit is a smart idea to produce, you should be producing more, because there's more units you could produce that would make you even greater profit. Your profit increases all the way up until MR equals MC, and then it starts to decrease. And that's why MR equals MC is the perfect sweet spot for production. There's no reason to produce anywhere else along the cost and revenue curve. Yeah. Look at this firm. This firm was producing somewhere that was not MR equals MC. And they made not enough profits. Can't you see that? Oh, wow, sir, it's me, Jonah Hill. Oh, man, that's really terrible that happened. Hey, the biggest thing you guys need to do is remember that MR equals MC. That is the golden rule of economics. MR equals MC. But what if we, like, don't do that? MR equals MC. What if we do MC and then we use the... MR equals MC.
Are y'all
not using MR equals MC?
What? There's rumors in the Twitter sphere. And if any of my officers are caught
not using MR equals MC,
they'll find themselves in prison with a snorkel duct taped to their mouth. And me
pooping
down that snorkel.
It's extremely vivid, thank you.
We love LA. We love to be here.
Okay, give me 30 seconds on the clock.
To maximize profits, what should MR equal? MC. To maximize profits, what should MC equal? MR. What is the rule of profit maximization? MR equals MC.
Damn! You did it!
No, Grant, listen, I know I gave some bad answers before, yes. But I understand the game perfectly now, and that does not represent me.
Okay, I like
so
that.
I'm ready to give good answers.
I like that.
That
I
does
like
represent
that. All right, that sounds good. That sounds good. If you don't know an answer, you can say pass, and we'll just move on to the next question.
Okay.
All right. Are
yes.
you ready?
Yes.
30 seconds on the clock.
To maximize profit, what should MR equal?
Santa Claus. Pass.
To maximize profits, what should MC equal?
Soap. God, I really hate that buzzer. Can we not do that?
Clock's ticking.
Pass.
What is the rule of profit maximization?
coffee.
Nope, we got it. We need an answer.
Yeah, no. Okay, no, then pass. Then. Okay.
MR equals MC is where profits are what?
Pass.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
How do you maximize profits?
France.
I already said that.
Okay, France. France. No, France. Don't, little
still
mustache.
Not the answer.
Little mustache.
No answer, man.
So,
say something.
No, stop saying. You said that already. Don't say France.
Give up.
All right. I have never seen a more embarrassing display in my entire career.
Please don't air this, okay? Please don't air this. You won't air this, right?
Oh, no. We definitely air. We always air it, no matter what we air. That's how we do it, my friend. Good night, everybody. Thanks for joining us here on Family Fights.
Why not?
I love that.
Intimate Jay-Z and Beyonce performance.
That was incredible.